Hi, I'm Sam with BatchStovez, and today I want to do a boil test using the new BatchStovez 10cm cook pot. Now, the cook pot is meant to replace the IMUSA mug. It doesn't have a handle, it doesn't have any rivets, and it has a nice anodized finished inside and out. You have a nice anodized lid, and it's slightly taller than an IMUSA 10cm mug. It's actually 100 millimeters diameter and 100 millimeters tall, or 10 centimeters diameter, 10 centimeters tall. This is meant to replace the IMUSA mug. I think you'll find it's going to be a great ultralight cook pot. The mug and lid by itself weighs less than 90 grams. And I think you'll find it's a good addition to any ultralight gear. We're going to use the BatchStovez BS 2.0 aluminum bottle stove. We have 1 ounce of heat. This is a 1 ounce fuel bottle. So we got 1 ounce of heat, and I'm going to go ahead and get that started. It'll take about 60 seconds to bloom. We have 2 cups of tap water. It's at about 66 degrees. And we're going to go ahead and get that going. Got our 2 cups of tap water. I don't know if you could see it. And I don't know if you can just see, but you still got a good inch and a half of room after you put 2 cups of water in here. This cook pot easily holds 24 ounces and has room to spare. Our stove is starting to bloom. We're going to put it on at 123.02. 123.02. Let's put the thermometer in there. And let's see if we can get the indoor temp. I believe the indoor temp's around 70 something. Let me see if I can get the just the indoor temp. Alright, looks like the indoor temp's around 71 degrees. I suspect that this is going to take around the 5 to 6 minute range. I would like to, I want to figure out if what affects the carbon felt koozie, which is an accessory for this cook pot. I want to see what effects the carbon felt koozie have on actual boil times. I don't suspect that it'll have too much of an effect, but as with any alcohol stove, slight variables and variations in temperature, water temperature, they all affect the boil time. So, but I suspect they'll be within a few, 30 seconds of each other either way. So it's really going to be a matter of preference. You can pick the pot up with the silicone lip guard and transfer it over to a koozie later after you boil the water, or if you're going to use the pot to eat out of or drink out of, that shouldn't be an issue. So you could do it that way, or you can cook it with the koozie on. It's really just a matter of choice, I think. So we've been on a couple of minutes now, and you can see that the temperature is climbing slowly. Now, you get a lot of questions. I get a lot of emails. Which alcohol do you prefer? And I prefer heat for the simple fact that It's very extremely clean burning. It's 99% methanol. It doesn't have the output, the BTU output of some of your other denatured alcohols. It actually has the lowest output, around 8,900 BTUs. Your SLX denatured alcohol and some of your other denatured alcohols that you can get at your big box home stores have a little bit higher output, but this is very clean burning, doesn't leave any kind of film on the bottom of your cook pot, and if you catch it on sale, it's very inexpensive. So that's what I prefer, and it's really just a matter of choice. And it comes with its own 12-ounce fuel bottle. So, you know, if you need 12 ounces, if you're going on a trip that you're going to need 12 ounces, you just take the bottle with you. It's a very lightweight plastic bottle. So, it's really, for me, it's a no-brainer. So we're coming up on around 4 minutes. And I can start to hear the stove making some noise. See if you can hear it in the video. We have quickly climbed to 192 degrees, 194, 195. And I think we're actually about starting to boil here at 127.45. 127.45, we're actually boiling. Pretty rigorous. 127.45, and we're at 210. As you can see, we're boiling. Now you can see the space that's left over, so there's a good inch and a half space. And this is great for a solo backpacker, and even, to be honest with you, even this pot, I designed it so that it would be big enough for a couple of people, actually. You know, a lot of the cook pots and a lot of the dehydrated meals and stuff, you know, you need one cup of water for most of the meals, maybe a cup for a hot beverage, and I think this would suffice for two people, because you can easily get 24 ounces in this, so that's 3 8-ounce portions. If it's during the summer and you're not even using a hot beverage, you're just making, you know, meals for breakfast, oatmeal or something like that, or heating some dehydrated food, then this should be sufficient for two people. And at 90 grams, I mean, it's very lightweight. So I believe the koozie does have some effect on the boil times. As you can see, that was probably in around the less than 5 minute range, or right around 5 minutes. I'll have to go back and look at the video to see exactly when we had a boil. But I believe it was around close to 5 minutes, if not less than 5 minutes. So this may have an effect, slight effect, on increasing the boil time. And it would make sense, I guess. It is an insulator, so it's going to keep the liquid, if you have cold, cool liquid in there, it's going to keep the liquid in there cooler. But then again, once your water is heated, it's going to also keep your water heated longer. It's going to keep it hot and warm longer. So looks like it's the stove's starting to go out, and stove's out at 131.05. Now, as I was saying before, you can have your pot koozie, and you can take it off, and then you can just take your stove and just transfer it over to your koozie, and then you can use your koozie to pick up your pot. So you don't have to have your koozie on there. You still have to be careful. This silicone lip guard is going to it's going to allow you to pick it up, but you're not going to be able to hold it too long. So you can transfer it over to the koozie, and then you can use your koozie to pick it up and hold it, and you know, use it to pour water and pour the hot liquid out. And so it works good for that. Let's see how well the koozie keeps the water insulated. Let's see what type temperature we got. So we had it up to 212. Of course, I've poured it into a cold container and then back into there. So we probably lost, I'm sure we lost some temperature there, but looks like we're still at around 188, 190 degrees. So that's pretty good. It's pretty good. So I'm Sam at Batch Stove. Stop by and see us, and have a great day.